فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وبعد. Inshallah, today I wanted to speak about Ahmiyatul Waqt, the importance that time has. And to remind myself first and to remind you all that time is a ni'mah from the ni'am of Allah Azza wa Jalla that Allah has bestowed upon us as His servants. And as you all know, that the ni'am of Allah are divided into two. Ni'am which are usul, their fundamentals, and ni'ams, blessings that are sub-branches. So the blessings of Allah are two types. They are either usul, their fundamentals. The fundamentals such as Iman, believing Allah Azza wa Jalla. Al-Imanu billahi ta'ala wa bima ja'a min indi. To believe in Allah and that which has come from Him. Believing Allah's names, His attributes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Believing in His prophets. Believing in the pillars of Iman. In general, all the six pillars of Iman. The prophets, the books, all of them. Al-Imanu bil qada'i wal qadar. All those are the ni'am that Allah has given you if He makes you believe in those things. Those are ni'mas. Also, al-amalu bi muqtada dhalik, and that Allah gives you the ability to act upon the iman that you have. It's a bless from the usul of the ni'am that Allah has given you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. From the usul of the ni'am are also having siha, health, and having afiyah, that you're healthy. Because these things are the things that helps you to act upon your knowledge, and that helps you implement that knowledge, and that helps you do the orders of Allah accordingly. They are ni'am, which are usul. Some are sub-branches, like al-muhafadatu ala nawafil al-ibadat. If Allah gives you the ability, and that He bestows that blessing to give you the ability to pray the sunnah, the sunan, qiyamul layl, to give you the ability to read the Qur'an and memorize the Qur'an. These are ni'am, but they're not usul, they are furu'. One of the ni'ams that are usul now is a ni'matul waqt, the blessings of time. It's from the usul of all these things that we're mentioning. Because all these ibadat and all these belief, they all occur within time. I wanted to bring to your attention, brothers and sisters, verses of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the importance of time. Allah said in Surah Ibrahim, الله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم وسخر لكم الفلك لتجري في البحر بأمره وسخر لكم الأنهار وسخر لكم الشمس والقمر دائبين وسخر لكم الليل والنهار وآتاكم من كل ما سألتموه وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها إن الإنسان لظلوم كفار. And Allah says, Allah is who has created the heavens and the earth, and sends down water as rain from the sky, and thereby brought forth fruits as provision for you. And He has made the ships to be of service to you, that they may sail through the seas by His command. And He has made rivers also to be of service to you. Then Allah says, and He has made the sun and the moon both constantly pursuing their courses. One leaves, the other one comes. One leaves, the other one. To be service of who? To be service of you. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمْ Service for you. And He has made the night and the day to be of service to you. These are ni'am. And he gave you all of all that you asked for. And if you count the blessings of Allah, never will you be able to count them. Verily, man is indeed an extreme wrongdoer. Wallahi, we are a disbeliever and a kafar, a zalum, an oppressor, a transgressor. We are. So in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us the ni'ams in which He blessed us with. And all these ni'ams that Allah mentioned are ni'ams that Allah put in day and night, which is time. Allah, the sun, the day, the night, the sun coming, the sun leaving, the sky, the heavens, all of these all occur within time. It's a ni'mah. After all of that, look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ. If you sit down to count the blessings of Allah and to put it to a number, never will you be able to count them. Then Allah said, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومُ. Verily, man is indeed an extreme wrongdoer, a disbeliever. Also Allah said in another ayah, وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ وَالنُّجُومُ مُسَخَّرَاتٌ بِأَمْرِ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ. In Surah An-Nahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and He has subjected to you the night and the day, the sun and the moon, and the stars are subjected by His command. Surely, in there are proofs for people who understand. Proofs for whose sisters and brothers? Proofs for people who understand. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِغَوْمِ يَعْقِلُونَ. فَأَشَارَ فِي خِتَامِ الْآيَةِ إِلَىٰ أَنَّ تِلْكَ النِّعَمِ فِيهَا آيَاتٌ بَالِغَةٌ عِنْدَ الَّذِينَ يَعْقِلُونَ يَتَدَبَّرُونَ. It's for those who understand, who ponder, they will realize the importance of the time Allah has given them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah says something like that in Surah Isra. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ آيَتَيْنِ فَمَحَوْنَا آيَةَ اللَّيْلِ وَجَعَلْنَا آيَةَ النَّهَارِ مُبْصِرَةً لِتَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَلِتَعْلَمُوا عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ وَالْحِسَابَ وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ فَصَّلْنَاهُ تَفْصِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this ayah, and we have appointed the night and the day as two ayat, signs. Then we have made dark the sign of the night, while we have made the sign of day illuminating, that you may seek bounty from your Lord, and that you may know the number of the years and the reckoning. And we have explained everything in details with full explanation. Allah also said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Surah Fussilat, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارُ وَالشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ لَا تَسْجُدُوا لِلشَّمْسِ وَلَا لِلْقَمَرِ وَاسْجُدُوا لِلَّهِ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُنَّ إِن كُنْتُمْ إِيَّاهُ تَعْبُدُونَ. Allah says, and from among the signs is the night and the day, and the sun and the moon. Prostrate not to the sun nor to the moon, but prostrate to Allah who created them, if you really worship Him. Again, Allah is reminding you the day and the night, which is the importance of time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He emphasized and showed how much He bestowed upon us and the importance of time and place, and what are allowed in the times and place, as He said in the Surah Al-Fatir, وَلَهُ مَا سَكَنَ فِي اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And from Him, from Allah, and from amongst His sign, subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions in Surah Al-An'am, Allah mentions in this ayah, and to Him belongs whatsoever exists in the night and the day, and He is the all-hearing, the all-knowing. It also brings me back to another important point, which is تَأْنِيبُ اللَّهِ لِلْكُفَّارِ إِذْ أَضَاعُ أَعْمَارَهُمْ. Allah scolding the kuffar for wasting their time. Allah said in the Quran, speaking about the kuffar, because they didn't benefit from their time and they wasted their time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says to the kuffar, أَوَلَمْ نُعَمِّرْكُمْ مَا يَتَذَكَّرُ فِيهِ مَنْ تَذَكَّرَ وَجَاءَكُمُ النَّذِيرُ فَذُوقُوا فَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ نَصِيرٍ. Did we not give you lives long enough so that whosoever would receive admonition could receive it? And the warner came to you, so taste you the evil of your deeds. For the ظالمين, the polytheist, the wrongdoers, there is no helper for them. Because why? جَعَلَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى التَّعْمِيرُ مُوجْبًا لِلتَّذْكِيرُ وَالِاسْتِبْصَارِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the life that was long that He gave to them could have been a means for them to ponder and to understand and take and receive admonition. وَمَيْدَانُ لِلْإِيمَانِ وَاسْتِكْثَارِ. Rather benefited from that time and benefiting to remember Allah and the righteous actions, this was nothing that helped them. They didn't benefit from it. وَلِذَلِكَ الْحَافِظُ ibn Kathir, in the tafsir of this ayah, he said, أوما عشتم في الدنيا أعمارا لو كنتم ممن ينتفع بالحق لانتفعتم به في مدة عمركم. قال قتادة: اعلموا أن طول العمر حجة، فنعوذ بالله أن نعير بطول العمر. حافظ ابن كثير said, hey, it will be said to them, أوما عشتم, did you not live in this dunya أعمارا, a long life. لو كنتم, if you were ممن ينتفع بالحق, if you were going to benefit from the time, لانتفعتم به, because you would have benefited from it, of your time that was given to you. قتادة said, اعلموا know أن طول العمر حجة. To have a very long life is a proof of Allah against you. So we seek refuge from Allah, that Allah gives us a long life in which we don't benefit from. And this brings me back to the narration of Imam al-Bukhari, or it brings me to the narration of Imam al-Bukhari that he narrated in his authentic book, the most authentic book after the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, أعذر الله عز وجل رجل أعذر الله عز وجل امرؤ أخر عمره حتى بلغه 60 سنة. Allah will not accept the excuse of any person whose instant of death is delayed till he is 60 years of age. There is no proof for you. Allah won't accept anything from you. No excuses, oh Allah this or that. Because the death that was meant to come to you, or the death that other people have got in a very early age, you got it delayed for you. You didn't benefit from that time. And take heed from it. Also, Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, مَنْ عَمَّرَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى 60 سَنَةً فَقَدْ أَعْذَرَ إِلَيْهِ فِي الْعُمْرِ. Imam Ahmad narrates in his Musnad on the authority of also Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, whoever is granted a long life until the age of 60, Allah has left no excuse for him. أي بمعنى أزال عذره ولم يبق له موضع للاعتذار إذ أهمله طول هذه المدة المديدة من العمر. Allah has now taken excuses away from you, because you were given a life for that long in which you could have benefited and taken lesson from it. And it brings me to the point of the poet who once said, وَإِنَّ امْرَأً قَدْ صَارَ 60 حِجَّةً إِلَى مَنْهَلٍ مِّنْ وِرْدِهِ لَقَرِيبُ. A person lives for 60 years. What excuse does that person really have? That's the truth. 60 years of your life and you didn't recognize and you didn't wake up. Naam. And this is to show you again the importance of time. The person who's been given a life of 20 years is not the same as the one who's given 10 years. And the one that's been given 10 years is not the same as the one that was given 5 years. وَهَلُمْ مَجَرَّى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swore by time to show its importance and its greatness. And there are ayat كثيرة فيها تنبيه إلى عظم هذا الأصل من النعم غير التي أسلفتها. The importance of time and its greatness to show that it's important and it's serious. رب الأرض والسماء, the creator of the heavens and the earth, swore by time. And this is to show you the qima of the waqt and the qima of the zaman. Allah said in Surah Al-Layl, سبحانه وتعالى والليل إذا يغشى والنهار إذا تجلى. By the night as it envelopes. So Allah swore by the night and by the day as it happens in brightness. So Allah swore by the day and He swore by the night. And they are both time. وقوله تعالى, Allah also said سبحانه وتعالى والليل إذا أدبر والصبح إذا أسفر. In Surah Al-Mudathir, Allah says, and by the night when it withdraws and by the dawn when it brightens. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا عَسَ عَسَ وَالصُّبْحِ إِذَا تَنَفَّسَ in Surah Al-Takwir, which means, and by the night as it departs, and by the dawn as it brightens. Who these are what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's qasam. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, in Surah Al-Inshiqaq, فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالشَّفَقِ وَاللَّيْلِ وَمَا وَسَقْ. Meaning, so I swear by the afterglow of sunset, and by the night and whatever it gathers in its darkness. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. By the dawn, by the 10 nights, meaning the 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijjah. عَلَى الرَّاجِحِ مِنْ قَوْلَيْهَا لِلْعِلْمِ. From the strongest view of the scholars. So Allah swore by the dawn again, and the 10 nights of Dhul-Hijjah. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى by the forenoon, meaning after sunrise, the forenoon, and by the night when it is still of darkness. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرِ by the time, verily man is in loss. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌّ by the Lord of the heavens and the earth, it is the truth. Meaning, what has been promised to you is the truth. Just as it's the truth that you can speak. Also Allah said, وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا ضَحَاهَا Surah Al-Shams. And by the heaven, and by him who built it, and by the earth, and him who spread it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ which we mentioned. قال العلامة ابن القيم الجوزي رحمه الله He said, إِنَّهُ يُقْسِمُ فِي الْقُرْآنِ بِأُمُورٍ عَلَى أُمُورٍ Allah swears in the Qur'an about some aspects for another aspect. فَيُقْسِمُ بِذَاتِ Allah swears by him, he himself, by his power and his ability. And Allah swears by the characteristics in which he is and his attributes. وَبِآيَاتِ And Allah swears by his verses and his signs. These signs, al-mustalzimu, they necessitate, li-ithbati dhati wa sifati, that necessitate the affirmation of his existence and his characteristics. وَيُقْسِمُ Allah swears, بِبَعْضِ مَخْلُوقَاتِ Allah swears by some of his creations. Why is he going to swear by it? Al-Allamah ibn al-Qayyim says, لِدَلَالَةِ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهَا مِنْ عَظِيمِ آيَاتِ To show that they are from his greatest signs. To show you that they are from his greatest signs. إِنْتَا كَلَامُهُ His kalam has finished there. So it is important, something Allah Azza wa Jalla swore by and emphasized on, how would one then not be able to know its seriousness and not benefit from time? Allah says in an ayah which I read before, which I'm going to read again. He's in a surah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ Surah Al-Asr. Allah says, by the time, verily man is in loss. Except those who believe in Islamic monotheism and do righteous good deeds and recommend one another to the truth, meaning they order one another to perform all kinds of good deeds, which is the ma'ruf, which Allah has ordained, and abstain from all the kinds of sins or evil deeds, which are the munkarat, and they abstain from it. That's what it means. And recommend one another to be patient from the sufferings and the harms and the injuries which one may encounter in Allah's cause during preaching his religion of Islamic monotheism or jihad. This surah is immense, Surah Al-Asr. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i, Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i said, لو ما أنزل الله على خلقه If Allah was to not send out on his servants except this surah, لكفتهم, it would be sufficient for the people. And Allah swore by it. In the Quran. I just want to bring to your attention the great scholar Fakhruddin al-Razi, who has a book called Mafatih al-Ghayth, which I don't advise many people to read. Because he had the belief of the Asha'ira and the creed of the Asha'ira. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah refuted him in his Kitab Taqdis al-Ta'sis. Naam. Fakhruddin al-Razi, an explanation of this ayah brought out some benefits. He said, أقسم الله تعالى الله سوه بالعصر the time لما فيه من الأعاجيب because of the fascination that are in it لأنه يحصل فيه سراء والضراء because the good and the bad they happen in the time والصحة والسقم and the health and the illnesses they happen in time والغنى richness والفقر they all occur within time ولأن العمر and because of the life of a person لا يقوم it doesn't stand بشيء نفاسة وغلال the person's life and his will not stand except with that فلو ضيعت ألف سنة if for example somebody was to forsaken 1,000 years of his life ثم after that تبت, you repent. وثبتت sorry لك السعادة في اللبحة الأخيرة, and then it became affirmed for you success in the last moments of your life. بقيت في الجنة أبد الآباد, you will then remain in Jannah forever. So it doesn't matter, you benefit from that last minute of your life just before you're about to die, then you forever will be the people of Jannah. وفعلمت, you done أشرف الأشياء, you done the best things of all your life. هي حياتك, your life. في تلك اللمحة, that last moment of your death, you were just about to depart from this world. فكان الزمان من جملة أصول النعم, remember that the blessings of Allah which He blesses us with, they are of those types that I mentioned before, which are أصول الفروع. And the time is of the أصول النعم, the fundamental blessings that Allah gives. فلذلك, and because of that, أقسم الله, Allah swore به, by it. ونبه, and Allah alerted سبحانه وتعالى على أن الليلة, the night, and the night at والنهار, and the day, فرصة, it's a chance, يضيع الإنسان, that the servant forsakes. وأن الزمان, that the time, أشرف, is most honorable, من المكان, in places, فأقسم به, that Allah swore by it. لكون الزمان نعمة خالصة لا عيب فيها, إنما الخاسر المعيب هو الإنسان. Time is not something that is that's put down, or that's got عيب, or mistakes or wrongness in it. It's you as a person. The Quran, that's what it showed us, in to showing us the importance of time. Let's look at the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The Prophet told us sallallahu alayhi wasallam in regards to the importance of time. The hadith is narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah on the authority of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, ni'matani, two blessings. There are two blessings. Fihima kathiru min al-nas as-sihhat wal-faraq. There are two blessings in which most people are in great loss. Good health and free time. They are a loss. لأنه غب means loss. Also, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam has told us that the time is something you will be questioned, and it's the center of question on the Day of Judgment. And Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated from on the authority of Abu Barzat al-Aslami that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, لا تزول قدماي عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن عمره فيما أفناه وعن علمه فيما فعل وعن ماله من أين اكتسب وفيما أنفقه ومن جسمه فيما أبلى. وقال هذا حديث حسن صحيح. الإمام الترمذي رحمه الله narrated on the authority of Abu Barzat al-Aslami that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, on the day of resurrection, the feet of a slave will not move till he is asked about his life, how he spent it, and about his knowledge, what he did with it, and about his wealth, how he earned it, and what he used it, and about his body, in what way he wore it off. Also, Al-Imam Al-Bazzar and Tabarani narrated in their kitab, Al-Bazzar narrated in his Musnad, Al-Tabarani narrated in his Kabir, on the authority of Mu'adh ibn Jabal, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَن تَزُولَ قَدَمَاءِ عَبْدٍ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ حَتَّى يُسْأَلَ عَنْ أَرْبَعٍ أربع خصال, عن عمره فيما أفناه وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه وعن ماله من أين اكتسبه وفيما أنفقه وعلمه ماذا عمل به. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the two feet of the servant of Adam will not move from near his Lord on the Day of Judgment until he is asked about four matters. One, about his life, how he spent it. Two, about his youth, how he took care of it. Three, about his wealth, how he earned it and where he spent it. Four, and about that which he acted upon from the knowledge that he acquired. Al-Imam Hakim narrated in his Mustadrak, في كتاب الرقاق من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لرجل وهو يعظه, to a man that the Prophet was advising, اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس, شبابك قبل هرمك, وصحتك قبل سقمك, وغناك قبل فقرك, وفراغك قبل شغلك وحياتك قبل موتك. قال حاكم: هذا حديث صحيح على شرط الشيخين ولم يخرجاه. That the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, narrated by Imam al-Hakim in his Mustadrak, في كتاب الرقاق, on the authority of Ibn Abbas, that the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said to a man he was advising, اغتنم benefit, five before five come to you. شبابك your youth, قبل هرمك before age comes to you. وصحتك your health, قبل سقمك before illness comes to you. وغناك your richness, قبل فقرك before poverty hits you. وفراغك and your departure, قبل وفراغك your freedom, sorry, قبل شغلك before your business. وحياتك your life, قبل موتك before your death. And this, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam clarified to us, أن العمر ونصابه الزمن, that the time is a portion of the questioning of the Day of Judgment. And it's an explanation to the ayah that so many people may assume and live in this world that they live in just to enjoy themselves and have fun and just play around, as though Allah created them for no purpose. Allah says in the Quran, Surah Al-Mu'minun, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. O servants of Allah, did you assume that Allah created you abathan, for a joke, or without any purpose or aim behind it, aimlessly? وَأَنَّكُمْ and you all, لَا تُرْجَعُونَ, you will not come to us? Is that what you have assumed? So my advice to all of you is, فَاجْتَيْدْ رَعَانِ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاكِ, strive, may Allah protect us all. أَنْ تَعْمَرْ عُمْرَكَ بِالْعِلْمِ النَّافِعِ, fulfill your life with righteous actions, وَالْعَمَلِ الصَّالِحِ, and righteous beneficial knowledge, بِالْعِلْمِ النَّافِعِ, beneficial knowledge, وَالْعَمَلِ الصَّالِحِ, and righteous actions, وَالْمَكْسَبِ الطَّيِّبِ, وَالْقُرُبَاتِ الزَّكِيَّةِ, and good earning, and purified closeness. إِحْرَسْ أَنْ تَغْذُو بَدَنَكَ وَأَبْدَانَكَ مِنْ تَعُولِ بِالْحَلَالِ الْمُبَارَكِ. Try to fulfill your body with good earnings and halal income. وَأَنْ تَسْتَعْمِلَ بَدَنَكَ فِي مَا يُرْضِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. And that you benefit from your body to use it for that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. وَحْظَرْ, and be protected and safeguard yourself. وَقَانِ اللَّهُ وَإِيَّاكَ مَوَاقِفَ الْخِزِي, from the places where Allah protect you and I from it, from the places of destruction. أَنْ تَكُونَ, from you to be from those, مِمَّنْ تَشْهَدُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَلْسِنَتُهُمْ, to be from those who their tongues witness on them the Day of Judgment. وَأَيْدِيهِمْ, and their hands. وَأَرْجُلَهُمْ, and their feet. بِمَا كَانُوا, that which they used to do. بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ.